Welcome to another unit of the ISM exercise set Business Mathematics, this time with a unit on Lagrange multipliers. Let's take a look at the exercise. Here we have calculate all possible extrema of the function f under the constraint g being equal to 0. A proof that they are valid extrema is not required. And here we have the function f and the corresponding function for the constraint g. First step we need to take to actually solve this exercise is we need the so-called Lagrange function. The Lagrange function results from the original function, here the part minus x squared plus 2y squared, then plus, and we have one additional variable, here only one, for each constraint. Here we have only one constraint, thereby only one additional variable. So here, it's original function plus lambda times g. Okay, we have the Lagrange function, so what to do with this? We're just continuing with the Lagrange function as if this were a normal extrema exercise. So meaning, first derivative, set first derivative equal to zero, solve corresponding system of equations. That's what we're going to do here. So first, we're going to calculate the three partial derivatives. Here it's three because we had x and y. Then we get in addition a new variable, the lambda, so we also have to calculate the first derivative with regards to lambda. Okay, so if we do this here with regards to x, we get minus 2x, and then for the last part, plus lambda. If we do this with regards to y, we get 4y plus lambda. Then for lambda itself, it's only x plus y minus 5. So here, that's our first derivatives of the Lagrange function. And these we have to set equal to 0, giving us here the first one, which we then can solve for lambda. And the second one, which we also can solve for lambda. Finally, the third one, which is just our constraint. And with this in mind, we can then start working our way towards a solution. In particular, we could equalize first and second. So here, equalize first and second, giving us, after some short reformulation, meaning division by 2, x is equal to minus 2y. This then, we can just insert into 3 in order of constraint, which then reads as minus 2y plus y minus 5 being equal to 0. And this results into y being equal to minus 5. This time we can insert back into the fourth one, giving us here, as a result, x being equal to 10. And well, then we have our possible extrema of 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5 being the extrema. And well, there's only one possible extremum. So at this point, we are finished with this exercise already. And well, I hope you enjoyed listening to this short exercise. And if you want to see more of these types of exercises, feel free to visit the rest of the ISM exercise set or take a look in the corresponding playlist. I say goodbye and see you next time.